cranes, if you have seen the cranes, huge cranes, I think so, you might have seen like this, a very huge crane is standing and it is lifting some weight like this. You might have seen that a heavy weight is, counterweight is also used here, you know. We use the counterweight. We use the counterweight here. In the crane, a counterweight is used here. If anything is being lifted, for example, the crane is lifting anything here, then what is the use of this counterweight?
To balance.
If this counterweight will not be there, so what will be the result? It will topple over. Okay. So basically, by adjusting this counterweight, the center of mass or center of gravity is adjusted at this, because the pivot should be here. While lifting the weight from the other side, the pivot must be adjusted here. The center of gravity must be here. If the center of gravity is shifted here due to the heavy weight, so what will happen? It will topple over to this side. Okay? Or if the center of gravity will be shifted to this side, it may topple over to this side. So to keep it in the balanced position, this counterweight is used. Okay? In the absence of this counterweight, if they are going to lift a heavy load, it may topple over on either side. Okay?
The diagram shows a wheelbarrow and its load, which have a total weight of 150 Newton. This is supported by a vertical force F at the ends of the handles. What is the value of F?
I told you that whenever you are taking the distance, you have to take it from the pivot. Clockwise and anti-clockwise moments must be taken from the pivot. So in this question number 5, you can see there's a wheelbarrow like this. The force is vertically upward and the weight, which is vertically downward. 150 Newton, we have to find out this force is required to be found. The distance from the pivot, this distance from the pivot is 0.75 meters. And the distance of the force from this is 0.75 meter. The total distance from the pivot of the force. You will have to see that how much is the distance of this force. 1.5 meters. Now here we have to find out F. F is the force which is applied vertically upward. Its distance from the pivot is 1.5 meter. Because you have to take the distance from the pivot. So we have to find out what is the force. Force, total distance of the force is 1.5. Force multiplied by 1.5 is equal to the distance of this weight. How much is the distance of the weight from the pivot? This is a distance 0.75. This is clockwise movement from your side and this is anti-clockwise. For a body to be balanced, the anti-clockwise and clockwise movement must be equal to each other. So solve this and 75 Newton.